back home from Ramstein. I was able to get rid of the Jaguar today. I lost my butt on that one, but I'm just happy to have that thing gone. That was the worst buy of my entire life. It gave me $5,200 for it, and I paid $8,000 for it. Easily the worst deal I ever made. And I just wanted to get rid of it and be done with it. But got the plates from it. Got those plates are for the Shelby. And then I'm running the plates that I got in this car for the Camaro, and the Camaro should be sold shortly this week unless the buyer backs out. So it should be just me and the Shelby here in Germany. Been running the 2011 SS back and forth from Baumholder to Ramstein. It's about a 30-minute drive. Not too bad. It's got a little switch of Autobahn, unlimited speed limit through there. It's a really straightforward car. Sounds perfect. Headers, GM Performance exhaust, poly bag. It's got a really nice shifter, very firm shift. Trembic 6060. I have noticed that going from first to second gear when it's like super cold, I'm talking, well, it's all relative where you live, but pretty cold, 20 degrees or below, until you get this warmed up and you get the trans temp of the temperature, it doesn't like to go in a second from first. It'll grind, it'll go in, but it'll grind a little bit, so like the synchros need a little bit warming up for that one. For some reason, it needs a little bit of time for the warm up and swell up in there and operate properly. Otherwise, it's pretty stiff. But yeah, everything else in this car works great. Even both the heat seaters work. All lights, no weird engine noises. Even the fifth gen Camaros have an issue with blower motors making obnoxious noises coming out of the vents. This one's pretty quiet. My Z01 Camaro I had back a couple years ago, 2013, had a squeaky blower motor, but didn't really bother me too much. That's when putting the windows down here to listen to the exhaust and turn up the music is for, right? This thing has the same sound system as the old one had, the Boston acoustics. It's pretty, it doesn't have a real hard bass hit, but the clarity is amazing. It's a very good sound system. You add a subwoofer in this thing, it's perfect. Doesn't need anything else. Also, the fuel mileage in this thing. It really isn't too bad. If you drive like a normal person on the highway, I would say this thing gets between 21 to 23 miles per gallon. And to me, for a V8, I say it sips fuel when you're on the highway compared to others. I mean, the Jaguar is disgusting. And they can get like 11, maybe 15 highway if you're lucky. The Mustang GT, it was okay. You could get 22 to 24 out of that if you would cranny it down the highway. Overall, it wasn't amazing, but it was pretty decent for a V8. I'd be a little sad to see this thing go. I really love this generation car. I like the interior a lot, way better than the 6th gen. A lot of people disagree. My preference. I should be saying goodbye to this thing this week. It'll be just me and the Shelby. I would hope that I'm plenty pleased with the Shelby. So far, I've been just test driven it, and I thought it was just absolutely amazing. So we'll see, and I'll do a video on that once I get used to driving that thing. I just want to do a quick little video on my way home. I'm over here looking like a dealer with all these plates and stuff. People looking at me funny when I go through the gate. But let me know what you guys want to see in the future out of the Shelby. not going to get too crazy with it, but if you give some suggestions, then I can try some things out with it and show you what you guys want to see. Definitely do, obviously, some polls and exhaust videos and stuff. Report back, you know, how I like it compared to the M3 I had and the ZL1 I had in the past, and we'll go from there. There's a bridge back the other way. I'm gonna come here and turn around. Mix exhaust, cab back. We're gonna do a pass through the bridge this time. I'm not gonna rev, I'm just gonna throttle through it in a second. Exterior shot, and I also have to take a leak. Beautiful little German field out here. Alright, so I'm trying to do an exterior shot for you, and I wanted to go open the passenger side door, but there it is. I couldn't remember where the unlock button was. But yeah, it's got, just like the ZL1, it has a little bit of accent lighting there. I'm not sure if it has any down there before, but it doesn't look like it, but just along the doors at least. Let's see, I think I got the halos on. Not quite as aggressive looking as the ZL. It's right up there. The mud tires there. It's got a nice idle to it. Really not much you really need to see, but it's more hearing, so I'm gonna put the phone down here, not too close, but give it a couple good revs so you can hear the system on it. She's a lot of noise. I wouldn't say a lot of bark, but she's a little bit of bark. I guess she's got a little bit of bite behind her bark, I guess you could say. She's not a lot. Alright, I'm gonna get back to being warm. Y'all take care.